Yes, you can sail the seven seas. Yes, you can put your mind at ease.
Just say, I'm very familiar with semen. Forget about it.
God damn it! God damn it! What the hell is this I found going through my refrigerator?
That's my commie, dear.
You're coming? You're coming? Look at this! What is going on in my basement?
I'm back good.
Sheila, dear, I think you're looking at this situation entirely wrong. You may see a burnt, crispy Russian Ruski, but I see a palate for a veritable sex god. Are you thinking what I'm thinking, dear?
Maybe, Dwayne. What are you thinking?
Makeover!
Get your ironclad ass in there!
You ain't waiting in line for bread in your country, but you're gonna be waiting in line for these biscuits, Zoom.
What about our mail call?
You boys can handle my mail sack.
But what? Who's gonna hand us our envelopes?
Earl, one of us is gonna have to open the bag.
It's a federal offense. I'm not gonna open that thing. I am not gonna touch that thing. It's your show. You open it.
Fine. Ladies and gentlemen, this here's the part of the show where we like to read the letter that you, our faithful viewer, send in. Let's see what we got today, okay? Yeah. Three letters, that's nice. Alright, the first one is from Susie. She writes to us from Appleberry, Wisconsin. Let's see what she's got to say. Oh, isn't that precious? Can we get a picture of this? Is it to her dancing? And was it? Oh, there must be some red trees. And oh, she's got that huge smile. But look at that. She drew it upside down. Isn't that just the sweetest? Her letter is, Dear Hank and Earl, is it true? Is the world really going to die?
Why don't you take this one, Earl?
Susie, you don't need to worry your pretty little head about anything like that. Of course the world's gonna die. But you've taken the first step by watching this here show and becoming part of the new America. If you watch this show, Susie, get yourself a trusty firearm and learn how to cook bills for your man. You can be part of a new America. A better America that's gonna rise from the ashes. So, Susie, the world's gonna die, but you are gonna live.
That is so beautiful. Thank you for your sweet letter. Now, here, why don't you take the next letter there, Earl?
This here letter's from... Oh, it's another one from Ali Mohammed Halablalabab. Yeah, the guy from Kyrgyzstan, Afghanistan. Yeah, better than the other ones. Let's see, this letter... Okay, this is the third time. If you are gonna be eating powdered donuts while you write us a letter, please take the time to be careful not to spill the powder all over. Look at me. You know what? We're not even going to read this one. It probably just says, Die Yankee Die, like the other two anyway.
I'm so sorry about that, ladies and gentlemen. Let's just go on to the third letter, shall we? Now, this one here is from Tom Grierson, and he writes to us from San Francisco, California. Oh. Let's get a picture of this if we can. Mr. Grierson, I'm not going to read your filthy letter on TV, but I would like to address your PS. Point one, Ronald Reagan did not end the Vietnam War. A lot of people believe the war ended in 1973, when in fact it only went underground, and it wasn't until our sainted leader took office that the war truly ended. Point two, Ronald Reagan did not single-handedly knock down the Berlin Wall. Earl?
Apparently you haven't seen the photographs on thegrudgereport.com that have Ronald Reagan, muscles glistening under the sun, with that same axe that he chopped wood in at his ranch, chopping down the Berlin Wall 3 whole days before the masses joined him.
Point three, Ronald Reagan has not been sainted by the Catholic Church because, A, he is not Catholic. What does being Catholic have to do with being a saint? B, he has not performed any miracles. His entire administration was a miracle. C, he is not dead. He's not dead.
I'm pretty sure he's dead.
Don't you forget it's time for my makeup minute! The only reason you're having this stupid show in the first place!
Rolling the promo.
And now Scamway Products proudly presents Sheila's Makeup Minute with your host, Sheila Haywood, and today her special guest host, Dwayne Gaylord.
Honey, what have you done to the commie?
He is just too fabulous for words, Dwayne.
Why don't you tell him what we did to him?
Well, we use our patented Scamway Retinol Cream. It's just $19.95. A bottle takes care of all those little wrinkles, firms and tones the skin just beautifully. And we made him over completely with our lovely, festive little Scamway necklace. Perfect for Valentine's Day or any day of the year. Just $4.95.
Gaudy as in.
It is, Dwayne, and let me tell you about this lovely, lovely medallion, just $9.95. You can be the most stylish person in the trailer park. Now, Scamway is looking for representatives, and if your husband is a worthless, unemployed sack of crap like mine, you will find it great to join our Scamway family. Oh, Dwayne, do you have that toning cream?
Oh, yeah, dear. No. No.
This is Scamway's toning and finishing spray. Perfect to add to any makeover. What is wrong with him?
Damn it, what did you do to the commie, honey?
I didn't okay, do anything mommy, to mommy. The commie. I just sprayed him with the finishing spray.
You know, it isn't tested on animals.
It's okay, commie.
All right, stay here,
we
commie.
We need to get him calmed down for the unveiling.
Beans?
All right. You just leave him with us. We'll keep him. We'll make sure he's fine.
Fine. Me and Dwayne will do the unveiling later in the show.
Jim?
It's so hard being fabulous.
It is.
Give me my sack, you heathens.
Fine. Sorry about that, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go ahead and play the next movie. Cletus, could you roll that, please?